Some lovely music from Hansel and Gretel, the opera by Ingeborg Humperdinck. Starting tonight, the Little Opera Company is having a performance of Hansel and Gretel. And I have in the studio with me two of the main performers. I have Hansel and Gretel in the studio with me this morning. I have Jillian Bonner and Anne-Marie MacIntosh. And just a brief note about both of them. Jillian is a mezzo-soprano from St. John, New Brunswick. And in 2001, she graduated from Dalhousie University with a Bachelor of Music and Vocal Performance. And following her graduation, she enjoyed teaching voice lessons. And now she is here doing her Master's of Music in Voice Performance at the University of Manitoba, studying under Tracy Dahl. Fantastic. Anne-Marie MacIntosh, who's playing Gretel, is an emerging Canadian coloratura soprano and has been praised for her stratospheric notes. I can vouch for them. I saw them in Gilbert and Sullivan just a few short days ago. And she is a winner of the Winnipeg Rose Bowl 2013. Jill won it just this year in 2015. Jillian, I should say. And Anne-Marie also is a graduate of the University of Manitoba program here. She graduated just this fall. So I have them both in the studio with me this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for coming in this morning.
Our pleasure.
I'm glad you could make it in. I know it was last minute for both of us here, so I'm very happy you could make it. Now, you both come from opposite ends. One, you're from Langley, BC, and Anne-Marie's from Langley, and Jillian is from the other coast. And let's start with you, Jillian. How did you get into opera? How did you start singing?
Well, I started taking voice lessons when I was 9. I began with violin when I was 6, and then voice lessons. And then it kind of evolved organically into opera, because it was just something I really loved doing. I found it so fun, and then I was in an opera. My first opera was Tosca with Opera New Brunswick, starring Wendy Nielsen, and it was grade 11, and that's when I really realized that this was something I wanted to pursue.
When did you start listening to opera, though? Because, I mean, most kids don't listen to opera.
Yeah, I didn't listen to opera. I grew up on musical theater.
Okay, well.
Basically. So,
yeah.
And I only started listening to opera probably when I started singing it. So I was about 16, 17, and I loved it. It was everything I loved about music.
Which is?
Oh, a passion, beauty, expression, and a way of singing that is just is art in itself. It's so technical, and people have to do so much work to create it, and I love it.
Do you remember the one piece or one moment you heard a work from an opera that really that captured you more than anything? Or
it was the Te Deum in Tosca, where Scarpia is saying that he's going to get Tosca. And I was in that chorus, and that was huge for me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And Anne-Marie, how about you? When did you first start getting into singing?
I'm quite similar to Jillian, actually. I mean, I didn't start taking voice lessons until I was 12, but I also started on violin, so I had some exposure to classical music from when I was about 7. And in a similar way, I was really into musical theater. Like, that's kind of mostly what I sang when I started taking voice lessons. I mean, I sang, obviously, classical music, but it was at a more like elementary level. I went to my first opera, at Vancouver Opera, I think when I was in grade 11. I saw The Italian Girl in Algiers, and I loved it, and I thought it was so hilarious. And I think that was the moment when I really realized that opera was everything that I loved about musical theater, with all the acting. Like, I didn't realize it was a play. Like, I didn't realize there was so much acting involved, and I think there was even some dancing in that production as well. But then it was that music that I loved, and the challenge. Like, I think I'm a person who really enjoys a challenge. And so that was, I mean, there's obviously a lot of musical theater music that is challenging, but that was the thing I enjoyed about classical music, is I felt I really was able to rise up to that and do some really interesting things with my voice. Mm-hmm. So I think that's what initially got me interested in that, as opposed to kind of continuing to pursue musical theater.
So speaking of challenges, you both play children. Mm-hmm. In this opera, Hansel and Gretel, based on the Grimm's fairy tale. How How do you approach that? How do you approach playing someone like a child? I mean, you just came out of Gilbert and Sullivan, where you're playing, you know, more of a sort of a mature woman. And do you have to change your voice, or do you have to, how do you approach it?
Well, I wouldn't say we change our voices too much. I mean, obviously you do some coloring in your voice that might make it sound more whiny or make it sound, you know, according to what the character is saying. But I think that that is the main thing that I have found, especially about the libretto we're doing. It's Anne Hodges' one. It's a little bit like updated. There's some more, because the older English text has some words that are really out of use now. But the newer one, I think it really, if you go along with what the text is actually saying, it allows you to really just embrace what the character is saying. I think that's, we did have a discussion with our director at one point and said, like, what age do you think our characters are? And she kind of said to us, like, well, I feel like you guys are acting the ages of your characters simply because you're going along with the text and you're just doing what the characters are doing and feeling the emotions they're feeling. And I think when you really tap into that, it allows you to embrace your inner child. I don't know. What do you think, Jillian?
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, your inner child is a boy.
Yeah. Yes.
Did you know that?
I think what I tried to do, like Anne-Marie said, is really look at the text. And mm-hmm. I mean, Hansel is like an 8-year-old boy and he is very whiny. So just incorporating that into my body language, I'm not going to lie, I did use a little bit of my younger sister in this role.
Did you tell her? Does she know that
she doesn't know that?
She's an inspiration for a boy role. Yeah.
But I think a lot of it, for me anyway, is body language and just how I move as opposed to how I use my voice.
Mm-hmm. I'm in the studio with Jillian Bonner and Anne-Marie MacIntosh, two of the main performers with Little Opera Company that's starting to tonight. This is the first performance with Hansel and Gretel. I wanted to ask you, too, what do you think, Jillian, what's the appeal of the story? Why is it something that has been with us for so many generations? And it's kind of a frightening story in a way, isn't it? What's the appeal? I mean, for kids especially, what do you think?
Well, I think it depends on the way it's performed, but I mean the general story itself is a timeless tale of good versus evil, and I mean it's a moral tale as well. Mm-hmm. I think that's how it began, you know. If you're bad, a witch will eat you. But
so simple.
But I think, well, the way we're doing it anyway, it's it's very, it can be very funny when performed that way. But the tale is absolutely timeless, good versus evil.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And Anne-Marie, what do you think? How is it performing with all these kids? I mean, there's a lot of young kids in this.
It's been great. The children's chorus is so wonderful. They've been prepared so well and they just sound gorgeous. And I think that it is really fun working with kids when you're trying to be a kid yourself, because you're like, oh, that's what a kid is like. And I think it's also so wonderful to be performing with children and seeing their passion for music grow. And it's really, it kind of reminds me of why I got into music and just the excitement of being in my first show and stuff like that. So
if there's kids that are listening to this, or, you know, parents that are thinking about getting their kids into opera, What words of advice or recommendations would either of you have for that? Or encouragement?
Oh, I would just say go for it. I think a lot of people see opera and even classical music in general as this kind of like high art form and it's inaccessible. And I think that just encourage the children to see, like, opera is a living art form. It's so fun. You get to be a person you're not on stage and get to sing some of the most beautiful music that was ever written. And I think that that's really exciting.
And I would also say, if your kid is interested in it at all, get them in a choir mm-hmm. or a chorus, and maybe they'll have the opportunity to be in an opera and see what it's actually like.
Yeah, you start out with the comfort of having people around you, so you're not just that one focus, and if you're good enough and motivated enough, maybe you'll be that shining voice that comes through. And well, thank you for coming in this morning.
Thank you for having us,
Jillian and Anne-Marie. And again, that's they're in performing with Hansel and Gretel with the Little Opera Company. It starts tonight at 7:30, and it goes tonight, Friday night, and then there's a matinee on Saturday. You can get your tickets. They're available at 942-5483, 942-5483. And it's going to be a fun performance. Sounds like it's going to be. a lot of fun for kids and adults. So I've lined up one more work from Hansel and Gretel, and it is the overture from Hansel and Gretel. And again, this is the version with Sir Colin Davis in the Staatskapelle Dresden.